Hi everyone, in this video, I'm going to show you how to give an amazing look to your terminal. For this tutorial, I will use item 2, Oh My Zsh shell, and the power level 10k theme. You can apply the same method to the default terminal app if you want. Let's start by installing item 2. It's super easy. Just open the browser and search for item 2. Click download. Unzip the file and drag it into the applications folder. Now open item 2. Its default look is very black and not cool at all. So let's add more colors to it. Go to the browser and look for item 2 color scheme. In this website, there are tons of color schemes that we can choose. I'm gonna try shades of purple first. Here we get an XML file containing the color scheme. We have to copy the content of this file and save it to a local file. I will use touch command to create a file, then edit it with Vim. Paste in the content and save it. Now we go to item 2 menu, preference, select the profiles tab, then colors. Click on the color preset dropdown in the bottom right corner, then import the file that we've just created. After that, click on the color preset again and choose the imported one, shades of purple. We can see that the colors of the terminal have changed. Cool. Now I will make the terminal window a little bigger, 128 by 32. Then restart the terminal. It looks better than before. Next step is to install Oh My Zsh shell. I have a separate video about it. Link in the description if you want to see. Basically, we just search for Oh My Zsh shell on the browser. Go to the page and copy the install command, then run it in the terminal. By default, the Robbie Russell theme is used. It looks good and simple, but we can make it even more amazing with a power level 10k theme. Let's go to the browser and search for it. Open the GitHub page. Scroll down to the Oh My Zsh shell section. First, we need to run this command to clone the theme to our computer. Then, we must edit the Zsh shell RC file to change the theme name to Power Level 10K. Let's copy its name. Then, open the Zsh shell RC file with Vim. Replace the Robbie Russell theme with the one that we've just copied. Save the file and restart the terminal. If everything is set up correctly, you will see this interactive configuration. It's asking to install the Maslow Nerd font. Yes, we need this font in order for some special characters to be displayed correctly. So press Y. Now the font is being installed. When it's done, we need to restart the terminal. Now Power Level 10K will ask us several questions to make sure that the characters are well displayed in our machine. If everything looks good, we just press Y. Now it's asking which prompt style do you like. I like the rainbow one. So press 3 to select it. Next, do you want to show the time of the command or not? Yes, I prefer to see it. So press Y. Then the separators can be angled, vertical, slanted, or round. I'll choose angled. Similarly, the prompt heads. I will choose sharp. And the prompt tails, I choose flat. Next, the prompt height. One line or two lines?
I prefer one line.
For the prompt spacing, I'll use compact.
Next, few icons or many icons?
I like the apple, the folder, and the git icon. So let's press 2.
For the prompt flow, let's choose fluent.
Then comes the transient prompt. If we choose yes, then all commands except the current one will be changed to this simple style.
For me, I like to keep all commands with the same style. So let's press N for no.
And the last thing is instant prompt mode. I've never tried it before, so let's select 3 here.
Now we should press Y to apply the changes to ZshRC.
And voila, everything looks really nice.
Let's try to create a new test folder and run git in it.
We haven't pushed this to GitLab or GitHub, so there's no GitLab Fox or GitHub Octocat icons.
Now let's see what happens if we clone the PCBook repository here.
Yay, it's the GitLab Fox.
If we go to the old My Zsh shell folder, we can also see the GitHub Octocat.
Awesome!
Now, let's say if you don't like this purple color scheme, you can always change it the same way as we've done in the beginning.
Go to Item 2 Color Scheme site and choose the colors you like.
For example, hopscotch. Copy the content, paste it in a local file, then open the preferences to import the file, and select it in the color presets.
The colors are now changed. Not bad.
I will try several other color schemes here for you to see.
This is whimsy.
This is Solarize Dark Patch.
This is Pandora.
This is Chester.
There are tons of other choices that you can try for yourself.
Please tell me in the comments which one do you like the most.
Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe to support the channel.
Bye bye.